Today, you're going to learn how to set up Adobe Illustrator for logo designs that utilize a grid. And then I'm going to show you some tips and some tricks for creating awesome logo designs in combination with grids. Sponsoring today's video is Milanote, the best place to plan and streamline your next graphic design project. Milanote allows you to generate ideas and concepts with ease, and then to evolve those creations to final design solutions. As you probably know, I use Milanote myself for my design projects, and you can learn more about their awesome project planning software later in today's video, and just how helpful Milanote can be for your creative design process. So before we actually design our logos, we of course need a grid to work with. Now today, as you might have guessed, we're working in Adobe Illustrator, and Illustrator does have a great built-in grid, and we can use this as a base for our designs. You can make the grid visible by coming into the View options and then selecting Show Grid. However, there are various different settings that you need to be aware of when utilizing this grid. Now firstly, I find it useful to use pixels as the ruler measurements, and you can right-click the rulers to change the measurements used. It's also useful to turn off the Snap to Pixel Grid option, as this can distort your selection and navigation as I've shown in previous videos. Now if we zoom into Illustrator, you're going to notice that each large square on my grid is equal to 50 pixels. This is my personal preference, and it does change depending on the logo I'm designing, but by default, I think Illustrator uses 72 pixels per square, which I find just causes issues when calculating distances. Now you can adjust these settings in the preferences window here, and I also have each small square equal to 10 pixels within the larger 50 pixel square. So again, this is entirely up to you and what you want to use for your setup. Now another setting that you want to be aware of is the Snap to Grid function. This can be both very useful and also very annoying depending on your design and what you're doing. But if I turn it off and then I go to make a rectangle, you can see that the dimensions move freely around the artboard. Now with the grid function activated, my shapes stick directly to each grid square on the line. So yeah, just think about what you want to be using for your logo design, and you might want to switch this on and off throughout the entire project. So now you've set up your grid for logo designing, let's delve into some really useful and handy tips. When a grid is used from the very start of a logo design project, scaling and then modifying the logo becomes a lot easier in the latter stages of the project. Also, a logo needs to stay consistent even after years and years of changes, so having things precise on a grid is really useful. The grid lines do help to provide some consistency to the logo design, and as a quick example, I've got a symbol here that I briefly made up. And you can see that it's two large squares thick, which on my artboard is 100 pixels. Now if I open up the transform window, I can type in 50% for the height and the width of my logo, and this will prove that one large square is half of my design. Now this is how a grid is useful for scaling, because you can judge and calculate proportions for your designs based on the grid alone. The next tip is to try and use geometric shapes as much as possible on your grid logo designs. I'm going to explain why soon, but quickly to demonstrate, I have the ellipse tool selected here, and if I hold down both the Alt option and the Shift key, and then click and drag, I can generate a circle that snaps to each grid line from the center. I can then copy this with Command or Control C, and then paste it in place with Command or Control F. It's then just a matter of repeating the process to end up with three circles. I can then select all three circles and then duplicate them by holding down the Alt Option key and clicking and dragging. The layout that you use for your shapes would depend on the logo design, of course. But for some greater detail, let's now take the pen tool and draw one single horizontal line. I can then duplicate it with the Alt Option key and then press Command or Control D to repeat the process downwards. So for the next step, you can either select everything and then use the divide function in the Pathfinder window, or you can use the Shape Builder tool located here. By default, the Shape Builder tool is going to unite shapes together, as you can see the plus icon above your cursor. So carefully click and drag over your selections, uniting parts that you want to use. And I'm going to make a very crude and a very random logo symbol that probably is going to look ugly, but it's just a demonstration purpose. And then to remove excess shapes, hold down the Alt Option key and then draw over those areas that you don't want to be used on your design. You will then be left with a solid shape for your logo mark. Now, using geometric shapes isn't just quicker than drawing things yourself, but you're guaranteed a crisp and a precise outcome. So the next point is something I've spoken about on my channel before, and that is not falling for mathematical systems. One of the most common systems is the golden ratio, but perfect geometry doesn't always appeal to the human eye. And actually, the golden ratio has been debunked many, many times. The mathematics for it actually are impossible to recreate, because a decimal point is never ending. And also, the Apple logo has been debunked because it doesn't even come that close to the golden ratio, mathematically speaking. But the point here is that you shouldn't restrict your creativity and the possibilities for your logo by complying to a strict mathematical system that is actually flawed anyway. But yeah, big thanks to Milanote for sponsoring today's video. I really do highly recommend it, and I've been using it for nearly 2 years now myself. You can easily streamline your creative process from start to finish on any project that you're working on, but also it's very easy to share your ideas and your projects with other clients or even work colleagues. So yeah, do check out the links down below for more information on Milanote, and start streamlining your creative design process in a more efficient way today. So there was a look at how to set up a grid for your logo designs, and then to go further on some tips and some points that you want to keep in mind when designing a logo with a grid system. Do you use grids on your logo designs? Please do let me know down below. Of course, if you want to keep learning essential and useful skills as a graphic designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Like and share my videos on social media, and until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.